Hello and welcome to the Advanced Nanocharacterization Facility, housed at the Department of Electronic Systems Engineering at IISc Bangalore. In this video, we will walk you through the cutting-edge Advanced Nanocharacterization Facility that we have here, which has helped the researchers to develop cutting-edge device technologies. In this lab, we'll walk you through around 19 distinct characterization capabilities, which has helped us probe device physics under a wide range of electro-thermo-mechanical and optical excitation conditions, which has helped us understand the fundamental physics and the robustness of the novel devices that we develop here.
Hello, so this is the glove box which is used for making and processing our devices in an inert condition. In the leftmost part, so this is a chamber which is having a stamping stage for making heterostructures of 2D materials. Highly controlled and precise heterostructures can be made using the customized stage assembly and high magnification microscope. This all is mounted on optical bench for possible further upgrades. Now this is a thermal evaporator integrated in a glove box to deposit materials under high vacuum condition. This is fully automated and we can deposit up to 3 materials simultaneously while making inert condition throughout the process. This is the wet bench area inside glove box to process devices and has space for tools like spin coater, hot plate, chemicals and related processes. Whole device processing can be done inside the interconnected glove box seamlessly.
This is the manual probe station which provides us the platform to carry out on-wafer device characterization. We carry out device characterization using this setup where we use specialized probes to measure devices on wafers as large as 6-inch wafers, which are focused using this high magnification microscope, which can go up to 400x of magnification. Once the devices are probed, we then apply electrical stress using a high precision set of SMUs, which can carry out tests over a large range of the IV space. For example, we can carry out measurements under moderate power regime, and also we can carry out measurements on the high power regime. In the moderate power regime, we can go up to 200 volts on the voltage scale, and in the current scale, we can measure up to 10 amperes in the higher side, and in the lower side, we can measure accurately up to 0.1 femtoamperes. For the high power measurements, we have high voltage measurement capability, high current measurement capability. In the high voltage measurement capability, we can go up to voltages as high as 3 kilovolts, and for the high current capability, we can measure currents up to as high as 50 amperes. So these SMUs that you can see in this rack can be combined to carry out specialized tests which might require more than one SMU. We do this using very specific technologies called DSP technologies, which allow us to carry out multiple IV-CV measurements. We also see an integrated IV-CV setup, which is the 4200, which allows us to carry out DC-IV, pulsed IV-CV measurements, and can measure, which the speciality of this setup is that it can supply pulses. It is an integration of pulse measuring unit, source measuring unit and CV. The pulse measuring unit can apply pulses from a few nanoseconds up to hundreds of microseconds. The CV measurement capability of this tool allows us to measure CV for the frequencies from a few kilohertz up to frequencies as high as 10 megahertz. All very specialized measurements such as involving memory effects, PBTI, NBTI effects are routinely studied using this SMU package. In addition to these SMUs, we have nanosecond pulse generator called the transmission line pulsing unit, which generates pulses as high as a few kilovolts, 2 kilovolts, with pulse widths as low as a few tens of nanoseconds to 1.5 microseconds. These pulses, once generated, are transferred to the device through transmission lines, which are then supplied to the device using very specialized RF probes, which help us carry out electrostatic discharge measurements and also probe physics of devices under ultra short time scales. In addition to these electrical measurement capabilities, we also have electro-optic measurement capabilities. For example, here you can see this microscope is integrated with an electron multiplying CCD detector, which allows us to measure electroluminescent signals emanating from the devices, transistors and diodes under high power, high current, high voltage stresses. This CCD is a has the single photon detection capability, which would allow us to detect even the weakest signal that comes out of the device. This is the semi-automatic probe station, which enables automated on-wafer DC-RF device characterization and reliability tests. This probe station is automated by a control software, which allows us to carry out automatic characterization of thousands of diodes and transistors in each wafer. This tool has been extensively used for technology development of graphene terahertz technology and high power GaN technology. We also have a dedicated RF setup, which enables us to carry out linear and non-linear RF measurements over a wide range of frequency from 10 MHz to 67 GHz. It is also equipped with two internal signal sources, a signal combiner, S-parameter and noise receivers, pulse modulators, generators, and a flexible set of switches and RF access points. This RF setup also allows us to carry out pulsed RF measurements with 20 nanoseconds minimum pulse widths. It also allows us to carry out in-fixture spectrum measurements using VNA calibration and beam embedding techniques. This setup provides us with a high frequency resolution capability over as low as 1 Hz with an accuracy of plus minus 1 parts per million. The overall setup reduces test time significantly and allows us to carry out efficient large wafer scale measurements.
Here is the atomic force microscopy setup installed in our lab, which is used to characterize different device properties apart from the general material characterization for which AFM is generally used. So here we have a collection of different AFM tips ranging from different modes such as contact, non-contact and tapping mode tips to sample to module specific tips. So we have variety of modules available in the lab apart from general topography. So starting from different module, we have STHM, we have EFM type of tip module, we have SSRM, we have SCM, we have MFM modes, we have high voltage lithography toolkit for contact mode lithography, and we have different biological modes as well. And apart from the different modes and the tips, we have a variety of chip carrier as well, apart from the general carrier that we have.
This is the Micro-Raman photoluminescence electroluminescence spectroscopy setup, which allows us to have non-destructive measurements for material analysis and as well as to investigate device degradation phenomena. This setup employs an optical microscope with 100x magnification capability, which allows us to achieve a spatial resolution as low as a micron. At the heart of this setup, we have two continuous wave lasers, 532 green nanometers green laser, 325 nanometers UV laser. We also have an integrated imaging spectrometer with two grating options, 600 and 1800. We have a software controlled motorized stage, which helps us in generating Raman photoluminescence electroluminescence maps in the devices during stress. We also have a Linkum stage, which we can use to control temperatures from liquid nitrogen temperature that is 77 Kelvin to temperatures as high as 600 Kelvin using the Linkum stage controllers. We also can integrate the cryostat with this Raman setup to study the Raman signals at temperatures as low as the liquid helium temperature, 4 Kelvin. In addition to these optical measurements, we can also have electrical biases applied to the devices using these micropositioners in this stage. And in the Linkum stage, as you can see, we have small positioners which we can use to probe the devices and generate Raman and photoluminescence signals during electrical bias. As I had just discussed, that we have continuous wave lasers, but to get temporal evolution of the Raman signals to study electron-phonon interactions and electron-photon interactions at ultra-short timescales, we also have accessories such as the Acousto optic modulator, which can generate laser pulses by chopping the continuous wave lasers with minimum pulse widths of around 100 nanoseconds.
This is the cryostat setup we have installed in our lab. So this setup is capable of reaching to 4 Kelvin of temperatures using closed loop liquid helium cycling. This equipment is suitable for optical, electrical and magnetic measurements. For optical measurements, this is integrable with the current Raman setup,
And for electrical measurements, we can interface the SMEs present in the lab for various DC, IV, pulsed IV and RF measurements by interfacing with these SMUs. And then there is an ability to introduce magnetic fields as well for the measurements. There is a separate controller to control the stage movement inside the liquid helium cryostat. This can be controlled using the piezo actuators using this controller. And this whole setup is mounted on an optical bench for efficient integration with the other tools present in the lab.
This is the deep level transient spectroscopy system, which is used to identify energetically deep traps which can be present in trace amounts in our semiconductors, which are otherwise not detected using normal IVCV measurements. The trap detection is carried out by measuring fast capacitance and current transients in diodes and MOS capacitor like structures under different bias conditions over a wide range of temperatures controlled using this PID controller, where we can control temperature from 77 Kelvin to around 800 Kelvin. And for the purpose of measurement, the devices are probed and loaded in a cryo chamber where vacuum of less than 10 millitorrs is maintained. This setup can be used for carrying out various modes of measurements, such as number 1 capacitance based DLTS measurements, number 2 current based DLTS measurements, and number 3 optical based DLTS measurements. In the optical based DLTS measurements, in place of temperature, we use optical excitations which can be fed externally through these optical windows for exciting the device for exciting the deep traps and measuring the current and capacitance transients. In addition to these measurements, we can also do current, voltage, temperature scans, which will help us in analyzing the various current conduction mechanisms that are present in our devices. This is the wafer level hot carrier reliability setup, in which we stress the devices over a wide range of stress times, such as ultra short times to long stresses, using a dedicated set of high power SMUs. Immediately after stressing these devices for a certain amount of time, we measure the device, the basic health parameters of the devices using optical excitations, using moderate power SMUs for IV measurements and capacitance voltage measurements to identify evolution of traps and defects in the devices. This is the CCD based thermoreflectance imaging setup, which measures the reflections from device surfaces and allows us to monitor the temperatures in the device active region. This setup employs optical excitations from UV 365 nanometers to NIR 780 nanometers wavelength, and coupled with state-of-the-art piezo stage, which allows us to nullify thermal expansion and other noise effects, helps us to get accurate temperature maps under electrical bias conditions of devices such as diodes, transistors. In this case, we can get thermal maps with a spatial resolution of around 250 nanometers under 100x of magnification. This setup allows us to measure steady state temperatures as well as temperature transients, thermal transients. In the thermal transients, we can measure with a temporal resolution of 50 nanoseconds. And we can also monitor temperature rises as low as 0.1 degrees centigrade when averaged over a sufficient long time scale. This setup is generally used in integration with pulse generators and DC power supplies, which when integrated together allows us to monitor electrothermal performance of our devices and help us to come up with proper thermal management plans towards development of robust devices.
This is the low temperature vacuum probe station designed and developed in-house in our lab. It has capability to do different tests ranging from DC, pulsed to RF probings using different SMUs which are present in the lab when interfaced properly with the setup. These tests can be carried out under high vacuum conditions and from temperatures which can vary from 77 Kelvin to 773 Kelvin using a combination of liquid nitrogen which is stored in the D-bar and the heating stage controller which gets input from the four sensors which are inside the chamber for precise temperature control.
There is a large sample holder inside which can mount multiple samples at a time, and this supports automation as well to do the long term measurements. The top optical window supports optical excitations to be done during the device characterizations.
We have an optical microscope to observe and capture high resolution images of our samples. This microscope provides us capability to observe samples up to 1000x magnification. This microscope has bright field microscopy and dark field microscopy capabilities with exposure time control up to a minute. Apart from the usual white light source, there is a high intensity mercury lamp to facilitate fluorescence microscopy. It has combination of filters and polarizers to get the best optical images according to the sample properties. It has capability of transmission microscopy as well for transparent samples.